Hey everyone, John at Freshwater Systems. In our ongoing series on answering frequently asked questions, today we're going to talk about filters for your water heater. What is a water heater filter system? Well, first of all, using the word filter is a little bit of a misnomer. What we're trying to do is protect the water heater from scale. Scale is probably the biggest destroyer of water heaters, tankless or tank. So these are really anti-scale products. How do water heater filters work? Well, again, they're not filters, they're anti-scale products. And they work by sequestering or keeping the hardness in solution so they don't come out of solution and start to scale up on the heating elements or on the bottom of the heater, or in a condition of a tankless type, it doesn't scale in all of the channels and orifices inside. That will kill these heaters. So what we're trying to do is protect them with these anti-scale devices. What are water heater filters used for? Well, precisely the protection. When we have any kind of hardness in the water supply, when it enters the heater and becomes really hot and the molecules start to go very fast, all of that scale mineral will come out of solution and create rock inside the heater. And when it does that, the heaters become less efficient, until finally they just die. So what we want to do is protect the heater by keeping those minerals from coming out of solution. And that's what these products do. How do you install a water heater filter system? Well, you want to get on the line, the cold water line that feeds the heater, so that you're going to eliminate or sequester these minerals before they get into the heater and create scale. So the installation is typically either a housing of some nature. In fact, the TAC or scale net type protector is a big blue housing that installs on the cold water line feeding the water heater, as does something like our hydro blend, or if you're using some level of phosphate. What does a water heater filter out? Well, again, these are not filters. What we're doing is keeping minerals from coming out of solution, becoming scale. So there's really nothing that is being filtered. If we had dirt and debris that's getting into the house and getting into the heater, you would definitely want something earlier, maybe at the point of entry, so that you protect the whole house from that level of dirt and debris. When do you need to replace the water heater filter? These are anti-scale devices. And the phosphate type or hydro blend, it slowly dissolves as water passes through the filter. And eventually you're going to have to replace it because the material is dissolved as water passes through it, and that's what gets inside the heater and protects it. Typically you're looking at annually. If you're using the scale net or TAC type product, that's going to last probably 3 to 5 years depending upon how much water goes through it and how much hardness you have in the water supply. What causes scale in a water heater? It is hardness. It's pure, lots of mineral in the water that's typically based from calcium and magnesium, and it wants to come out of solution very fast, and especially in that hot environment of a water heater, it comes out very quickly. And it attaches itself to the electric heating elements, it clogs up the pathways in a tankless, and it settles on the bottom, creating scale on a gas-fired heater. And all of that creates a problem for the heater. They become less efficient because they gotta heat through all of that scale and rock before they can heat your water supply. Studies have shown that getting the mineral out prior to the heater is going to save the efficiency of it, and it'll live its whole life. Absolutely, the best way to protect your water heater is to remove the mineral with a water softener, like an ion exchange water softener. But if all you want to do is protect your heater, these products, Hydro Blend, Scale Net, is probably your best defense against scale. What causes sediment to accumulate in a water heater, and how do you get rid of it? Well, Again, if that sediment is coming from the outside, if you're on a well water or maybe a city supply that's got a lot of debris in it, you might want to think about putting a filter at the point of entry so that you capture that stuff, because it's getting not only in your heater, it's getting in your dishwasher, it's causing havoc with all of your fixtures, your shower heads and so forth, and your toilet hardware. So if it's getting into the heater, all heaters have a drain at the bottom of it. And periodically, you might have to turn the water supply off and drain it out to try and get as much of that out as possible. How do you flush your water heater, and how often do you need to do that? Well, you really shouldn't have to do it very often if you maintain it properly. Protect the sediment that's coming in on your main water supply. Protect it from scale with either a softener or an anti-scale product. But if you're still getting debris in there, maybe you get some hardness that accumulates, there's a drain at the bottom of it. You turn off the incoming water supply and you open that bottom drain and let it drain out. You can usually hook a garden hose up to it and run it to either a slop sink or maybe even out of the garage, depending upon where it's at. How frequently is really going to be based upon how much accumulation you're getting in that water tank. And periodically, while you're draining it, you might want to turn the inlet on a couple of times just to kind of stir things up so that it goes out the drain. Well, that's all I've got. Be sure and like this video, subscribe to our channel, and check us out on our website, freshwatersystems.com.